Okay, so now we've seen how this works on code level. You really need just to follow these four steps that I'm showing here again. Creating the component, then adding the component to a container. So for example, we can create a J button and add this button to a J panel. And then for the events actually to be fired and to received, to be handled, we need to do these two more things. First of all, we need to register a listener. Typically for that we create a new class, but could be an existing class that is just extended. So we register the listener. We register a listener with that component, and in the listener then we need to define that relevant callback method. In the example here we were working with an action event triggered by a button, and such an action event then triggers a callback method called action performed in the action listener. And the action listener obviously needs to implement the action listener interface for this to work. If you've listened closely and if you followed the example in NetBeans, then you may actually be able to answer this bit more advanced questions here. Advanced question here. How many action listeners can listen to a control? None? Exactly one? Or as many as you like?